I'm Markus Kettunen, and I'll present the first half of our work on Ristra's foundations and Ristra path tracing. Daji Lin will present the other half. Our goal in light transport is to enable noise-free real-time rendering of complex scenes. Brute force won't be enough. We must evaluate the right paths. We will need online importance resamplers like Ristra, extended to path tracing. We do that in this paper. You might have thought Ristra is a direct lighting algorithm. By treating longer paths akin to virtual point lights, we extended Ristra to simple global illumination. In this paper, we derive Ristra PT, which resembles between path spaces of different pixels. Ristra PT is based on our mathematical foundation of Ristra, generalized resampled importance sampling, which allows resampling from arbitrary domains and modifying the samples on the fly. When Ristra PT finds a path that transports energy, it resamples it to other pixels and frames, retaining proper path geometry, for example through glass. Resampling between paths in the previous and current frames improves the sampling distribution, which reduces noise. So what is Ristra again? Ristra is reusing samples from other frames and pixels by resampled importance sampling, RIS, for a better path distribution. Pixels store a sample and its contribution weight, which replaces the division by PDF in Monte Carlo integration. Each pixel generates a new random sample and resamples between it and the previous frame by weighted RIS. The pixels resample between random close-by pixels and the sample in the current pixel. The selected sample is moved to the current pixel. The final sample is evaluated for a color estimate, and the next frame follows. The exact pipeline may vary, but the key idea is that Ristra is chained RIS. So then how do we move paths between pixels? Moving a path to another pixel is called shift mapping. A shift mapping takes a base path and outputs a similar offset path in another pixel. Ristra DI and GI use the reconnection shift. The offset path is connected to the next vertex of the base path. This reuse of path vertices as they are is simple, but creates problems with specular interactions. Proper path reuse requires changing the path as we go. Here we have sampled the orange path with a specular reflection. The blue offset path approaches from a different direction. The only continuation follows the specular reflection. By reusing vertices, we get a direction that carries no energy. Performing the ideal reflection at resampling requires generalizing RIS. There are also other reasons for generalizing RIS. Ristra was not based on known mathematics. RIS assumes independent samples, but sample reuse correlates them. This loses theoretical guarantees and led to all kinds of weirdness. Our generalized RIS supports correlations, and we give formulas for correctness and convergence. GRIS allows sample modification for reuse between arbitrary domains. We expect our foundations to provide a baseline for future work. Next, we start with RIS and show how trying to reuse it for Ristra naturally leads to GRIS. The goal is to generate one or more samples proportionally to a user-given target function, p-hat, defining the target PDF. We start by generating samples with a known PDF. We evaluate the reciprocal PDFs of the samples, the target functions p-hat, and give each sample a resampling weight. We then select the output sample proportionally to the resampling weights. If we add more input samples, the result PDF approaches the target PDF. While we have no access to the results' exact PDF, the contribution weight allows unbiased integration. But what if we want to maximize sampling quality by resampling from all samples in 2 pixels? So, take all the samples, evaluate the reciprocal PDFs and resampling weights, and select proportionally to the resampling weights. Easy. Except that the realized PDF is wrong. The inputs cover different parts of the domain. We get overlaps, and these resampling weights lead to double counting. We must normalize with proper resampling MIS weights, MI. Talbot proposed the balance heuristic. The PDFs can now vary per sample. We must replace the 1 over M weights with MIS weights. Nothing else changes. When we include the MIS weights, the PDF becomes much better. More samples would make it even better. But what if the input samples come from resampling, like in RISTER? We don't know the PDFs. When we integrate with resampling, we don't divide F by P. We don't even know P. We multiply F by W, which is an unbiased estimate for the reciprocal of P. RISTER uses the same trick for evaluating the resampling weights. We assume the samples have unbiased contribution weights. We evaluate the resampling weights with contribution weights in place of the reciprocal PDFs. This simple case of GRIS is enough for simple cases of RISTER. We can now use the resampling result for other pixels. We simply use the final contribution weight in the resampling. Let's then resample from 2 pixels that store 1 sample each. We don't expect much improvement due to the low overlap. We get an acceptable distribution, but we should have used a shift mapping to maximize the overlap. The target PDFs are quite similar, but we should shift the samples from the other pixel left. We should utilize our knowledge of the path spaces to maximize efficiency. The best shift is not the same for all samples. Not applying the transformation corresponds to blindly reusing vertices as they are, even when it doesn't make sense. We should apply shift mappings at path reuse. So let's modify GRIS to support shift mappings. We assume the input samples lie in arbitrary domains omega I. Integration happens in omega. We map the inputs to the integration domain with the shift mappings Ti. When we map the input domains onto the integration domain, we get overlaps. To fix the double counting, we need MIS weights like before. How do we evaluate the MIS weight for a point like this? We need to know the strategies that can generate the sample. For this, we map the sample backwards to all possible input domains. We apply the MIS weights and poof, the double counting is gone. So let's see what actually changed. We assume the input samples come from arbitrary domains. The resampling weights are multiplied by Jacobians, and we shift the selected sample to the target domain. Let's take the 2 inputs from before and resample with GRIS. The second sample gets shifted like this. The shift mapping pretty well aligns the sample PDFs. We evaluate the resampling weights and choose. The result PDF is quite good and would improve even more in a real case when you resample from more than 2 pixels. This improved sampling distribution explains the quality improvement.
Hi, I'm Dachi. Let me introduce how we turn the GRIS theory into a RISTER path tracing algorithm for real-time rendering. The key is to design efficient shift mappings. We want to connect to the earliest suitable vertex, postponing the connection if necessary. We use two conditions for the connection. First, we check the material roughness. The reconnection vertex and previous vertices on base and offset paths need to be classified as rough by a threshold. This avoids drastic changes in BSDF values. Another condition is a distance threshold to avoid short connection segments, which create geometric singularities. We reuse the random numbers to create similar path segments when we postpone the reconnection. Instead of finding a connectable vertex during the shift, we assume that the offset path is similar to the base path. With this in mind, we precompute a vertex on the base path and check if the offset path agrees with this vertex to validate the shift, which is likely to be true. We also decide vertex connectability by the selected material lobe. Imagine a ceramic teacup. Reconnections to its surface should be avoided for specular highlights. But reconnection is favored by the diffuse component, which dominates the reflected energy most of the time. Our strategy of determining connectability by the sample lobe improves both sampling speed and quality. Our Rister PTU works with any shift mapping, as long as GRIS is properly applied. We just described the hybrid shift that combines random replay with reconnection, compared to the naive reconnection shift which always connects to the earliest vertex. The context-aware hybrid shift avoids excess sampling noise with the distance condition and the roughness condition. Still, Rister PT with the reconnection shift produces a better result than Rister GI. Although both using the naive shift, Rister GI assumes the reconnection vertex to be diffuse and doesn't use proper resampling MIS weights. This makes it faster but produces bias and more noise, especially for glossy materials. Using the default hybrid shift, our method can also handle common types of caustics, like light passing through glass and concentrating on the supporting floor. But there are cases where the hybrid shift works poorly. For example, caustics cast by a small distant highlight. This is because a vertex on the window acting like a virtual light source is considered too smooth for reconnecting. Handling this case better is interesting future work. Now, let's see results in some more interesting things. Here we compare our method to Rister GI on an RTX 3090 in real time. Our method produces the glossy reflections of the poles with good quality. They are completely missing in the Rister GI result, rendered in equal time. Here's another thing. Note the quality difference of the chandelier. Let's see some animated results. Unlike path tracing, our method finds good samples even when the door is nearly closed in this scene. All frames are equal time, without denoising. Here's our method in another scene with Rister DI for direct lighting. And here we compare with pure path tracing. Rister DI for direct and path tracing for indirect. And change to Rister GI for indirect. Notice how we improve the glossy reflection. In conclusion, we generalize RI theory to correlated candidate samples from arbitrary domains via shift mappings. We apply the theory to light transport to prototype Rister PT, which enables efficient and unbiased path reuse for long paths by resampling. It captures many bounds diffuse and specular lighting in real time. We have not covered convergence analysis and offline rendering results in this talk. Please see the paper for these and much more. For future work, we expect better shift mappings to improve the handling of caustics, add support for volumes, and overall improve Rister PT's efficiency. It would also be great to experiment with designing denoisers for Rister's correlated samples. We also expect our findings to lead to further improvements in gradient domain rendering. And that's our presentation. The paper, video, and code are available in this project page through this QR code. Thank you for listening.